Beetle and I just, she'd got some money from working in London. She left her job. And in June of 1950, we set off for France. I had not been to France since 1938 when I went with my parents to Knokke-le-Zoute for a week holiday. So it was all incredibly new and exciting. I read books about France, of course. And we went first to Paris, and then we went down to the south in a bus, a Phocien car, which took 2 days to go via Lyon to Nice. And it was wonderful. And then we took the bus along to St Tropez, which was in those days just a small fishing village. I mean, it was quite smart because I think even then Brigitte Bardot and people had gone there, but she wasn't known at all. It was quite a smart Saint-Germain-des-Prés kind of place to go. And we put up in a little pension called Au Bout du Monde. And we lay on the beach and got sunburnt because we both thought we didn't get sunburnt because we had dark complexions, because we'd never been anywhere near a sun as hot as the one in the south of France in June. And we still made love in a very burnt condition. And then we set out to walk from Saint-Tropez to a place called Ramatuelle, a little hill village about 11 kilometers out of Saint-Tropez. And it was a very long walk with our luggage, and we had those non-pliant antique sandals which rubbed in every possible place that they could. Even when they didn't touch you, they seemed to be creating blisters. And we walked along and walked along, and eventually a French army lorry came along with two guys in it, and they stopped and they said, it was all like an American musical, where are you going? And we said, Ramatuelle, Allez, and off we went. And we found a little room with a woman called Madame Isnard. I think it was £3 or so a week, for 5,000 francs, I think it was. Francs were about 1,200 to the pound. And it had a room and a bed and a big bed on in the attic and a kitchen. Of course, it didn't have any running water. You had to go to the fountain in the village. And we were there for 6 weeks. And every morning I sat with my portable typewriter and worked on a novel. I worked and I worked and I worked, and it was all about a little boy going to Charterhouse or an equivalent of Charterhouse and all the terrible things that happened to him. But it was written in a style which I had learnt from Somerset Maugham. And what I learned from Somerset Maugham, particularly from Of Human Bondage, which I read when I was 15, was that there was a way, so to speak, of representing your own pitiful experience. Maugham had stammered and had a miserable time at school, and he created a hero who was lame, which stood for the stammer, called Philip Carey. And what I noticed in Maugham, which gave me the incentive to become a novelist, was that you can process experience in a cold, clear way so that it eliminates, you hope, self-pity, but enables you nevertheless to use your own personal experience. So I set about doing that. And Beetle read the pages, and she seemed to think they were okay. And in the afternoons we made love, and then we walked to the beach, either to that beach, L'Escalier, or to that beach, which was called Pompilon. Pompilon was where the American forces had landed in August of 1944. It was completely deserted, vineyards in front of it. Now, of course, it's a huge high rise and all the rest of it. And we used to walk down there, or to the Escalier. And one time at Escalier, there was a Swede, and he was standing above us. We didn't take our clothes off at Escalier because there were too many people, but he stood up there, and this voice came across the beach, Adam and Eve, which is a sort of strange moment. Anyway, we took it to be some kind of a blessing. It's easy when you're happy. Anyway, we went to Escalier, where we could take our clothes off and swim naked in the beach. And I remember some French couple came and sat miles away from us. I hurriedly put my clothes back on again, and they were saying, "Bougez pas, nous sommes aussi des naturistes." Anyway, it was all fine. We had a good time. And then it all got a bit sad because we were going to have to leave. Happiness was very fragile. And Beetle was unhappy because she was happy, and I was unhappy because she was unhappy, which is a not unknown thing to happen to both of us all through our lives. And I went back to Cambridge.